Hello friends, myself, Dr. Satya Mandal, a psychologist and mind therapist. We all are going through a very tough time, which is out of our imagination. We could not even imagine that one day we will face this type of situation. We are now in shutdown, in lockdown, or in isolation. But it may be willingly or unwillingly, we have to admit this and obey the system of the government administration. The government administration, local administration, medical staffs are doing very hard to save our life. But here my question is, why some mental disorders are increasing highly in our country? Because till today, with the awareness program of government administration, we all are aware about the COVID-19 infection. What are the physical symptoms? What are its treatment systems available with us? But what about the mental well-being of the population, which I feel we are lacking behind regarding the mental health awareness? Before this pandemic, the mental health illness and mental health disorders rates are increasing faster. But due to this pandemic, it's increasing very fast. That's a big issue. You ask yourself, are you aware what is your mental condition now due to this pandemic, due to this lockdown, due to this shutdown, due to the isolation period? We are not even asking ourselves what we are going through mentally. We all know and aware about what we are going through physically. But here my question is, if you will not mentally strong, if your mental condition will be not strong, then you cannot fight with the diseases. We cannot fight, never, because weak mentality means, weak mental strength means weak immune system. So it is directly proportional. So if we want to cure, we want to get rid of this pandemic, or we want to get rid of this COVID situation, we have to be mentally strong. You may be infected with the virus, or you are going through the isolation period, or you are safe but going through the lockdown shutdown. Because as a mental health therapist, we are seeing some of problems, some major problems which are occurring, which are increasing very highly. Like, number one is addiction. Yes, since we have no day-to-day busy schedule, we are addicted towards social media, first thing. Next, alcohol addiction, a drug addiction, yes, smoking addiction. Any type of addiction is injurious to our health, both mentally and physically. But still, we are addicting. We are day by day more addicted towards some sources. Youth are more addicted nowadays with the social media and video games. That's one big issue, which is directly affecting the mental health of that person and creating anxiety disorder, stress disorder, mood swings. And if you are suffering with lockdown, shutdown, isolation, you are also going through the stress factors, anxiety factors, panic factors. Third thing is excessive fear. We are afraid. We are afraid of many things. We are now afraid of going out, meeting new peoples. We are afraid of our life. We are afraid of our everything in our circumstances due to the excessive fear imposed by the system. But the system, we are trying to make us aware, conscious about the fact which we will be going through. But the population of our country, maybe they were aware in some way, but they are much more afraid of that fact. Their fear level is very high nowadays, which is also creating many disorders like cardiac arrest, like panic attack, like stroke. So these are the main problems which are creating. So here my question is, how we can balance mentally and physically? How we can create mental harmony by ourselves? Yes, we definitely can follow some simple steps which can help us to be mentally strong. Let us discuss some of facts which you can follow by sitting at your home. The first thing is, avoid all the news resources. This is the first thing you can do it. Avoid all the news resources from now itself. Avoid, delete social media, newses, WhatsApp, Instagram chats regarding COVID-19 virus, yeah, TV resources. You must avoid it to remain mentally healthy. Second thing, create and maintain a balanced routine life. You should plan your sleeping time, your working time, your daily activities. You should plan, neat and clean, plan it, because it will decrease your mental chaos, mental conflicts. It will definitely decrease. If you are going through the lockdown and shutdown period, then definitely start practicing some healthy habits. Yes, this is the need of the time. We can start practicing. We can learn new skills. We can learn about meditation. We can learn about yoga. We can learn about deep breathing. We can learn about spiritual practices, which are not only helpful for our mental well-being, also it's very much helpful for our physical well-being. To fight with this COVID, to fight this pandemic, we need to be mentally and physically healthy so that we can fight it. So start some good habits, start and practicing it. Next, start reading some books. Besides spending hour by hour in social media, that's Facebook or YouTube, start reading good books. It may be your favorite comic books, story books, self-developmental books, motivational books, yeah, spiritual books. But leave your mobile aside and start reading books. That will enhance your mental stability, that will enhance your understanding power, that will enhance your perception. Yes, reading books are a very good habit, because we all know that a good book is much more better than thousands of friends. So leave your mobile aside, leave your social media aside, leave your WhatsApp and Insta chats aside, and start reading books. At last, we can do self-analysis. Yes, this is the best time, because generally we were busy in our daily stops when the thing was normal, when the thing was easier. So at that time, our life routine was very hectic. Our daily schedule was very hectic. We even did not get some of moments to analyze ourselves. But this is the best time, which not only create a mental strength, but also you can plan about your goals. You can work on your visions. You can start working on your different aspects of your life, like health, relationship, profession. It may be prosperity. It may be your goal planning. It may be your business planning. We can start analyze. If you cannot work on these areas, then you can also work on yourself, on your inner self. That means you can work on your emotions. You can work on your feelings. You can work on your self-development. Yes, this is the best time. So these are some simple steps we all can follow during this pandemic to fight it mentally and physically. We all are the fighter. We cannot get away from it. We have to fight, because we have to live. So start practicing healthy habits to be healthy both mentally and physically. Thank you, and take care of your health.